We will, of course, be talking a lot about tapestry art in our conversation today. But before we do, well, you introduced Dovecot Studios, and I'd like to know a little more about it. And you also, I guess, said a little bit about its identity. But could you tell us a little bit more, maybe about its history and sort of mission statement, if you will?
Yes, sure. So Dovecot's an absolutely fascinating and genuinely, I think, a unique place. We were founded in 1912, so off the back end of the arts and crafts movement and the influence of William Morris, and were founded by a wealthy Scottish family, the Bute family. And the Marquess of Bute wanted tapestries. He was a real enthusiast for sort of medieval revival architecture. He built Castle Cock in South Wales, and he built his incredible house, Mount Stuart, on the Isle of Bute. And he wanted medieval style tapestries for that. And rather than go down to Morris and Company and buy tapestries from Morris and Company, who were still making tapestries at that point, he poached a couple of artist weavers from their studio and invited them to come up to Scotland and start a studio up here. So that's how Dovecot was founded, on the sort of ethos of the way William Morris wanted tapestries to be made. But really throughout the 20th century, Dovecot has evolved and come to understand or create tapestry that was very much synonymous with the particular time periods in the art world as it evolved throughout the 20th century. So it created modernist tapestries with artists like Robert Motherwell, and then the artist we're going to talk about, Archie Brennan, was really influential in modernizing the studio still further and really experimenting with tapestry and making it a very, very creative medium. And now we still continue to follow those joint ethos of working with in the lines of traditional craft through the sort of Morris and Company route, but really also creating modern, contemporary, influential tapestries with artists who have an affinity or have an interest in what we're doing. So the most recent well-known project that we did was the Chris Ofili tapestry that was part of the exhibition he did at the National Gallery in London 3 years ago now. So yeah, big range of work.
So promoting art history as well as contemporary art.
Yeah, well, they definitely work. Our studio works in a contemporary way, with contemporary artists or modern artists. But we definitely have our roots in a history, I suppose.
So Dovecot was born, you mentioned, at the start of the 20th century. And
yes.
I like this podcast series of mine to sort of also be a way for people to find out more about art history, speaking of art history. So you mentioned that it was born around the time of the arts and craft movement. What does that mean?
It's very much it's quite an English-led movement, really, come off the back of the work of William Morris and the Pre-Raphaelites. But really, it was the idea that traditional crafts were dying in the face of industrialization and the Victorian era. And it was a movement that brought handcrafted objects into the world of art again, and saw them as art, even if they were a handcrafted chair or a handcrafted tapestry, embroidery, or whatever. They saw that as part of art. You know, the art practice should not be separate from hand making, and obviously as a particular building style as well. Arts and crafts buildings particularly well known, but yes, it was quite pretty influential on a small period of culture in the sort of beginning of the 20th century before Art Nouveau and Art Deco probably took over as interior design styles, and the world of art leapt into surrealism and Bauhaus and that direction. So it's a particular moment in time where both come together, probably between late 1800s to about 1910, I suppose.